All right. Welcome to DRT. DRT stands for Dirty Rotten Tricks. Okay. So let me use somebody with hair. Anything with hair.
Hi, brother.
Now come out here, Billy. All right. So I'm going to use Billy because I trained Billy to take really nasty evil hits. So, and we'll get into the nasty evil hitting part in the systema portion. We'll see. So what did we start with? We started with handout. We started with brush, grab, hit. Brush, grab, hit. We transitioned into body block, basically boxers, body block, or what we call the hairbrush technique. This is an entry. Okay? A lot of cool things we can do with this, right? These are the only two moves. Okay? That we need to really work on. Okay, we're just gonna get nastier and nastier at this. I used to make a rather controversial statement that if you just spent 3 months doing this movement, you could go toe to toe with most black belts on your feet with a high probability of being able to protect yourself. Why? Because 99% of everything that they're teaching you in traditional martial arts distills down to this. Okay, whether you're doing traditional Taekwondo, Shotokan, Shorin-Ryu. Most of the kung fu styles. How many people have done a traditional martial art in the past? Just wait. Okay. How many have not? Just wait, see. Okay. So you guys have no clue what the hell I'm talking about, right? But you see people doing this, right?
Yeah.
You see people doing this, right?
Yeah.
People doing this, right?
Yeah.
What's the first 2/3 of that move?
Moving.
1, 2.
Yeah.
1, 2. When the hand comes down, oh, when the hand moves across, when the hand moves up. But because of the way, now if you're from a Chinese style, you might see it like this. That's the... Right? Now it looks familiar, doesn't it? Filipinos do it this way. And life sucks, right?
Yes.
Once you just, like I was telling this young lady over here, once you distill down to pure biomechanics, pure principle, all the arts look the same because truth is universal. So whether you have no training or you come from other arts, you're doing the same thing. We're just knocking away the non-essentials, the stylistic variations, and giving you what you really need, the bare essentials. Does that make sense? So, in this particular segment, we're going to drill a little bit deeper. Our primary form of delivery is going to be the brush, grab, hit, using a hammer fist. Okay? So, everybody take your finger, touch the hinge of your jaw, point towards your nose, towards the tip of your nose. This way.
Ooh,
this way.
Yeah.
You might want to take those earrings off, sweetie.
Okay.
Okay? This is your worst nightmare. Okay? That is the 7th cranial nerve. You got a good one. You got a good one, too. You got a good one. Towards the tip of your nose.
Oh.
This way. So, this way. Feel it?
Yeah.
Now, what I want you to do is I want you to walk up to 3 or 4 random strangers, say, hi, how you doing? And go like this. Hi, how you doing? And just point towards their nose. And don't hit them, because it will suck. But I want you to get the angle and direction for that point. I want you to wire it in that you can find it on 3 different people. Go. Okay, point towards my nose. You'll know. Now press. That's better. So you have to press to see if the head actually turns.
Okay.
So it's going the right direction, right? That's what we want. Go ahead, baby. There you go. So make sure it moves. That's right. No difference?
I thought this was going to be homework.
Oh, hell no. You go pull up as many MMA fights as you can.
Anybody that gets hit here gets knocked out.
Exactly. There's 5 points on the head that if you look at 80% of all MMA fights, you're getting hit in one of those 5 places.
Right here, the temple, right here. I've seen them get hit here and get knocked out.
It's usually because you hit them somewhere else. But these, you put these in and people just go out. towards the nose. That's the direction.
But is there a better finger? Is there a certain finger that's better to use? Or?
There is, but that's really just nitty-gritty.
Okay.
If you can't get 80, we work off the 80-20 rule.
Okay.
You can spend your whole life adding little pieces that just slow you down.
Yeah.
Get the big parts first. Like in traditional kyushojitsu, they're going to teach you to hit the hands first or the arms because that sets up these points. I'm not going to teach you to do that.
Yeah.
Because all you got to do is hit that point harder.
Yeah.
The theory behind traditional kyusho is the harder I hit the arms, the lighter I can hit the face.
Yeah, okay.
But there's all kinds of shit that can happen. So if I can bridge you, if I can pass your guard and whap you as hard as possible, I've already sent the shock back down to the arm. So I can literally come in, buzz you, and if I don't have you completely buzzed, I have you stretched out.
Right.
So I can come back, reactivate it, and get it again. Do you have it in the neck?
Yeah. Let's go, yes.
Right? So I can come in, tenderize the meat, and maybe the fight's over already. But if not, I come back. Now I activate the arm points, and I go back in again. And if I do it right, his head's coming towards my weapon. Because I'm not just doing this. It's coming in. I'm coming out. So I cheat. Here's the next drill. Billy. So we're going to start again from our reference position. Just for now. Okay? Now, I'm showing this based on a punch. However, here's something I want you to understand. I don't care what's going on past his wrist. If he puts his hand out like he's going to push me, that's the same angle as a punch. Isn't it? Didn't it come at me the exact same angle? Filipino martial arts does not equate their defensive tactics or their protective tactics with the attack. They equate it with the angle. So if he comes at me with a punch, I can defend it this way. If it's a push, same angle, same way. Choke, same thing. Hair grab, same friggin' thing. Right? That's what I meant when I said this will take care of just about anything from the front. If it's coming at you in a straight line. If it's coming at you in a curved line, then I use this one. Here, where I come opposite side. Or I use this one. Right? Then I turn the head, he falls down again. Right? But the whole idea is slow. As I come in with this, now, who's in structure, him or me? At this range, ladies, your elbows hit like sledgehammers and ice picks, okay? You can do just as much damage at this range as he can. Because these are nice, hard, pointy things. But now we're going to make it worse, because now we're going to stick these hard, pointy things into soft, squishy things. So as he comes in now, I'm going to brush check and I'm going to brush and grab this. As he brushes, now Billy is roughly my size, right? So for people who have a real big height discrepancy, I'm going to show you a couple variations, but this is the basic. We know where that pressure point is. Put your finger in it. It's really that simple. As the strike's coming in, brush check, I'm offline. Put your finger in the hole. Do that about 10 or 15 times until you can consistently control the wrist, put your fingers in the spot, and get the head to turn. When you can do it 10 to 15 times with just your fingertips, put your fist in there. These two big knuckles right here. Okay? If you're a little bit gun shy, put your hammer fist in there. Use that knuckle. Right? Same movement, right? So I can be outside. I can be inside, as long as my angle is right. Got it? Your homework assignment after today is to go to YouTube, pull up as many MMA fights as you can where there's a knockout, and notice where the majority of them get hit. 80% of the knockouts I see, this is one of the sweet spots. This is where they're almost always hit. So if that's the case, let's just train to go there. Right? Let's just not be satisfied with hitting any old place on the head. Let's be a little bit more precise, right? Can we do this? Be gentle and kind, because your partner gets to go next. All right? We'll work on some pressure point stuff that will put them to sleep. Then I'll show you some other cool things that you can do that'll just hit them with the ground. Go. Thank you.